Hi everybody, today I want to show you a fast resetting 7-segment display counter. Let's look at the size first. It's very compact for what it does. And it's also infinitely expandable, so you can add as many digits as you want. Yeah, and it does what the title says, so every time you give it a signal, it increments the score by 1. And of course it also has an automatic carryover. You can see now we go from 49,999 to 50,000. If you want to, you can also control the digits individually, so just need to power those droppers here for pulse, and then it would increment the individual digits. And yeah, the best feature about the system is the fast reset. So it doesn't use a piston tape, that's why you can reset it very quickly, as you can see. Just takes about 1 to 2 seconds and it resets to 0 again. The transition of the digits is very smooth, it's well synchronized. It's not 100% perfect, but the way the system works, it's actually not really possible to make it 100% perfect. The system can also handle inputs every 8 redstone ticks, or 16 game ticks, so you could use it for a stopwatch or something similar. Just FYI, the system has a little flaw if you would try to input frequencies between 21 and 25 game ticks, the system would not work, because the transition from the 9 to 0 doesn't work, it's just a little flaw of the system, also something I can't really avoid. So if you have random inputs, then make sure that there's at least 26 game ticks or 13 redstone ticks in between. So you can see if I press a wooden button, you can't actually spam it, this is already okay, system would always work reliably. By rearranging the part in the back, so this observer, rails and door system, you could also make a downwards counter. As you can see here, now we can't decrement the score. Also the carryover works, and you could also reset it to 999 again. System is able to count upwards and downwards is also possible, but it would definitely require a little bit more space, so maybe I'll make a separate video at some point. Right, so now I'm gonna show you how to build it. I'm going to do the upwards counter. If you're interested in a downwards counter, then you could check out the world download. The only difference is the part in the back, as I said. Okay, so let's do 2 digits. It's really repetitive, so it's enough if I show it for 2 digits, but you can of course add as many as you want. Okay, so I've already built up the 7-segment display. Let's add an input for incrementing the score by 1. Just add a piston for an observer, and the observer would power this block, and we'll add a redstone test line here. Okay, so now let's add a repeater here, points into a block, powering this dust, which powers this block right here, and then we put a dropper on top, facing upwards, and a hopper on top. Now fill up this dropper completely, it doesn't matter which item you have, cobblestone, iron nuggets, yeah, any spare item would do. Then we need 2 comparators here. Put this one on subtract mode, and here we need 2 redstone dusts. Another comparator here, also on subtract mode. This one, that doesn't matter. Powering a block, and another dust right here. Then on the back of this comparator, we can put a redstone block. So next, this dust here powers this block here. And we have another comparator right here, powering another block. And now here we add a line of 10 blocks, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Put down some redstone dust. Here we need a slab on top. Yeah, we could use all slabs, doesn't matter what we have here. Also, could technically also use slabs at the bottom. Okay. Also dust here, and then dust there, and here we put down another comparator on subtract mode. In the back we need a hopper, and fill it up with 3 stacks and 14 at least, could also use 16, doesn't matter. And this comparator powers this block, here we have a torch, then we need a sticky piston for redstone block in front, which would power this line here, this is the reset. Okay, then we also need another slab here, and a repeater, powering those blocks, dust on top. And we put down another repeater and connect it to this wire. So it's important that you have a slab here, so yeah, it's a diode, so the signal doesn't go down again. We also need an observer here, facing that direction, powering this block. Okay, and now we can add some repeaters. So we need 10 repeaters, one for every digit. Put them all on 3 ticks of delay, like so. And on top, we also need repeaters. Again, doesn't matter if you use slabs or full blocks here. And those are on 1 tick of delay. So now we need trapdoors, or you could also use hoppers, doesn't matter if you have wooden trapdoors or iron, and put them right here. Also add blocks here and put torches on top. Now we add some observers here on top. And then doors. Also, this case doesn't matter if it's wooden or iron. Yeah, just in case you have a iron farm or villager crop farm nearby, you should use iron doors. Then on the last one, we need a normal trapdoor. Also, again, doesn't matter if wooden or iron. Then add another trapdoor here. Here we can use observers again. More doors. And observers on top. And top again, trapdoors. So let's fill this up so we have just alternating trapdoors and observers, like this. So now we just have to connect the numbers to the segments. So a little general explanation how this works. So each observer and door combination represents a number. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. And now we have to connect it to the segments. So all numbers except 1, 4, and 7 would activate this bottom line here. That's why we leave out 1, 4, and 7. So now we have an observer here, 2, 3, not 4, 5, 6, 7, not 8, and 9. Okay, now we need some blocks again. Then we put rails on top. The last one has a block. And then you need either powered rails or activator rails. Now let's connect the second segment. So here we need everything except 2. And you need 2 observers. So not 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Again, need some blocks. Here we can fill this up for a normal block because we're gonna put rails on top. And I'll just add rails here again, and here we have a block, so we don't need this one actually. So rail placement is always a little bit directional. If you're building it in the, what's that, if the rails go north-south, then you will have issues like this. In order to avoid that, just need to extend the ends, then you can easily place those rails, and then you could remove those again. And if you're adding the next rails top now, just need to extend those ends, and then you can place those again. So if you're building in a north-south axis. For the next segment, we need 0, 2, 6, and 8. So place rails here. And I think it should be obvious how you could make the downwards counter now. Just have to invert the numbers. So instead of going 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., you have to go 9, 8, 7, etc. So the next one will be everything except 5 and 6. Then we have a gap, 2 blocks, and add those again. You need a block and the rest is rails again. And we fill up those blocks for the rails. And now everything except 0, 1, and 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, no 7, 8, and 9. And this time we leave out 1 and 4. And the last one is 0. No 1, 2, 3, but 4, 5, 6. No 7, then 8, 9. And now we just need to add the inputs into the segments. So make something like this and put comparators on top, except the top one. Then we need a comparator here and dust in front. There we go. And now we can connect the rails to those inputs. So at the bottom, we do something like this. So we need to add a little bit of extra delay so it's synchronized, because yeah, it takes longer to reach the upper segments. That's why we add this little chain here. So this one is downwards facing, like this, goes into a block, powers the sticky piston, and then we need some cauldrons, and we have to put water in. Okay, I can also do the next one. So if we just go down and towards the display again, and here we have another sticky piston and a cauldron. So the next one goes like this. Again, sticky piston, and here we put the cauldron here. Now let's connect the fourth segment. It's very straightforward. Just need two observers here, and then sticky piston and cauldron here. The next one is a little bit more tricky, so we take an output from this rail server here, and sticky piston is below. So in order to activate it, we go over here, then we add another door on top of a slab, as well as the piston here, the observer here would power it, that's why we need a slab. Then we add the door here, and another observer powering the piston. Now we can also add the cauldron front and add water to it. So the next one will be put here. Then the sticky piston and the cauldron in this position. Then we need two observers for the top one. Block here and a downwards facing sticky piston. And add the cauldron, fill it up with water. Okay, now you can check out if your first digit works properly. So we should get a 0 now. Perfect, now let's cycle through. Also check if the transition from 9 to 0 works again. Okay, now in order to immediately reset, we have to power this piston here with a pulse that's about 1 second long. So you could add a button here. If you have an external signal coming in, you could actually, yeah, because probably you don't have a manual input, you could go that direction. Power this block here with a repeater and add another slab here, dust on top. Okay, this would also work if you have an external input. Okay, let's put it back in for the manual. So yeah, dust is there, so we can reset it like this. Okay, now I'll show you how you can do the carryover for the next digit. So we take an output from this dust line here, from this comparator, power this block, and then we go down. Then we add two more pieces of redstone. Add a comparator in subtract mode here in the back, put down a hopper, fill it up with 3 stacks and 14 again for signal strength 10. Then we do a block, torch, and another block. And yeah, the rest is pretty much the same, except instead of having a redstone block here, you could use a hopper if you don't want to use a hopper because you have worry about lag. Then you could also use a chest, but you have to fill it up completely. So I'll just use a hopper here, because one hopper is not really that bad, to be honest. Okay, then yeah, it's pretty much the same. So here again, you need a comparator, pointing into a block, dust, then two comparators here, abstract mode, dust, like this, and here in the back we have the dropper again, just completely filled up something, and the hopper on top. And the rest is pretty much the same, so I can follow the steps from here again. That's exactly the same for the next digit. And yeah, if you want to increase the digit by one, you need to power, for the next digit, you need to power this dropper right here. That's all you gotta do in order to increase it. Let's also take a look at the reset line. So over here, we have already 5 digits built up. So this was the input with the button. We power this piston directly here. And like I showed, it goes through those lowest blocks. And then we have a slab here, and then a full block, or a slab, doesn't matter much. And this is the reset line. Alright, so thanks a lot for watching. I hope you have a nice day. Bye bye.